Here's a fun fact. Nuclear Hurricane was the name of my thrash metal band in high school. I know, I don't look it, but... As summer turns to fall and the East Coast prepares for the heart of hurricane season, it's nice to know that President Donald Trump has a plan for how to combat these terrifying natural disasters with the use of lethal force. In the latest, wait, is this an Onion headline or is this reality moment of a presidency chock full of them? Axios reported in late August that Donald Trump has repeatedly raised the possibility of dropping nuclear weapons into hurricanes to dissolve them before they ever endanger land. Quote, they start forming off the coast of Africa. As they're moving across the Atlantic, we drop a bomb inside the eye of the hurricane and it disrupts it. Why can't we do that? Trump reportedly asked aides during one hurricane briefing. Need a visual of what that might look like? Think the Death Star blowing up Princess Leia's home planet of Alderaan. It's devastating. Now the response to the idea was, let's call it muted, according to Axios. Quote, you could hear a gnat fart in that meeting, one source in the room told the site. People were astonished. Sidebar, and this is why I give you the really important stuff. Gnats, and all insects, do in fact pass gas. Know what doesn't? A jellyfish. Trump, for his part, denied the story using his customary third person. Quote, the story by Axios that President Trump wanted to blow up large hurricanes with nuclear weapons prior to reaching shore is ridiculous, he tweeted amid the G7 meetings in France, adding, I never said this, just more fake news, end quote. Now, you can decide who you believe in this back and forth, although I'll note that Trump has said more than 12,000 untrue things since coming into office, according to a count maintained by the Washington Post's fact checker blog. So for me, I'm most interested in knowing whether Trump's idea, nuking the Canes, nuke them, might actually work. After all, if Bruce Willis, Steve Buscemi, and Ben Affleck can plant a nuke on a meteor in outer space, save the world, what a story. Why can't we, you know, just blow up a few hurricanes? It all makes perfect sense. Now, the answer to that question is, well, it doesn't work. And it would probably be hugely, hugely dangerous. Or so says the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration. Oh, just them. Now, according to NOAA, quote, apart from the fact that this might not even alter the storm, this approach neglects the problem that the released radioactive fallout would fairly quickly move with the trade winds to affect land areas and cause devastating environmental problems. Needless to say, this is not a good idea, end quote. Now, is that explanation not satisfying enough for you? How about this one? And this is a shout out to all you nerds out there, quote, a fully developed hurricane can release heat energy at a rate of 5 to 20 power 1013 watts and converts less than 10% of the heat into the mechanical energy of the wind. The heat release is equivalent to a 10 megaton nuclear bomb exploding every 20 minutes, end quote. Right, I followed all that. So if I'm reading that right, it means that a hurricane is stronger in terms of energy than a nuclear bomb, like way stronger. And yes, way stronger is a technical term. It's in all the scientific textbooks. Quote, over my 35 years as a meteorologist, I have received calls and handwritten letters from people proposing this, tweeted John Morales, the chief meteorologist for NBC's affiliate in Miami, who knows a little something about hurricanes, adding, quote, I gently try to explain to them that according to NASA, a hurricane can expend as much energy as 10,000 nuclear bombs during its life cycle, futile and obviously dangerous, end quote. Now, just because dropping a nuclear bomb into a hurricane wouldn't work, doesn't mean Trump is the first person ever to consider doing it. He's actually far from the first. Way back in 1961, the head of the US Weather Service said in a speech that he could, quote, imagine the possibility someday of exploding a nuclear bomb on a hurricane far at sea, end quote. Right around that same time, the Pentagon formed something that was called the Project Plowshare, which was aimed at finding non-military uses for nuclear weapons. Jack Reed, a trained meteorologist, wrote an extensive proposal to Plowshare at the time that proposed the idea of dropping nuclear weapons into the eye of hurricanes. Now, Reed believed that the heat produced by a nuclear explosion would, in effect, blow up the eye of the hurricane and, in so doing, derail or significantly weaken it, maybe even take it off its course. So how would the nuclear bomb be injected into the storm? Not by plane, but by submarine. You never even saw that coming. But the science community now agrees that a nuclear weapon into a hurricane just wouldn't work. There's also this, nuking a hurricane would be illegal. under the Peaceful Nuclear Explosions Treaty between Russia and the United States, didn't know about that until today, there are strict limits on how and when the two superpowers can use nuclear weapons of any sort for any purpose. Now, none of that stops Trump from considering it, of course. Nuking hurricanes is in line with his long-held fascination with and trust in nuclear power and nuclear weapons. All the way back in 1984, Trump talked about the threat and promise of nuclear power. In an interview with the Washington Post's Lois Romano at that time, he suggested he could handle nuclear negotiations between Russia and the United States. Quote, "It would take an hour and a half to learn everything there is to learn about missiles," Trump said of his hypothetical negotiator role, adding, "I think I know most of it anyway," end quote. That was 1984, folks, not 2019. More recently, Trump issued a nuclear threat in January 2018 to North Korean leader Kim Jong-un on Twitter, and it went like this, quote, "Will someone from his depleted and food-starved regime please inform him that I too have a nuclear button, but it is a much bigger and more powerful one than his, and my button works," end quote. Trump's nuclear button might work. It just doesn't work on hurricanes. And that is The Point. We make new Point episodes every Tuesday and Thursday. Check them all out.